Industrial IoT is not easy. Connecting older devices, what we call brownfield, to the internet and then to the cloud is something that can be challenging. CloudRail makes it plug and play, literally, with Azure IoT Central. Felix from CloudRail is here to show us how on the IoT Show. Hi, everyone. This is the IoT Show. I'm Olivier, your host. Today, we'll talk industrial IoT. And for that, I have Felix from CloudRail. Felix, thanks for joining the show. How are you?
Well, thanks a lot for having me. Doing great.
Yeah. So before we jump into this topic of industrial IoT and how it can make it can be made easier or easy to use or implement and deploy, tell me a bit about yourself. Who are you and what is CloudRail?
Sure. So I'm Felix Kollmar. I'm actually one of the co-founders and CEO of CloudRail. And with CloudRail, our job is to basically connect the factory to the cloud, so enabling industrial IoT.
Okay. And we're saying a lot, you, Microsoft, us, and other people, that industrial IoT, it's its own thing, right? In the realm of IoT in particular, it has its own, you know, acronym, IIoT. And why is that? Why is it different from other industries, other businesses? What is particular about industrial IoT?
No, absolutely. I mean, you're talking about industrial assets, right? So you're really talking about factories, heavy machinery, often pretty expensive machinery. And those machines are coming from different decades, different OEMs, are often custom made. So you're really, really talking about really heterogeneous environment of machines which never have been designed to be connected to the cloud or to be used in an IoT environment. It's really those 20, 30, sometimes 40-year-old machines, which you now need to somehow connect to the internet, versus in classical IoT, those consumer gadgets, which you can just buy new ones, basically. But industrial IoT, that would be probably $1 million for a machine, right? So yep. You never, ever do that.
Yeah. So very often old hardware that has a lifespan that is way longer than what we used in the consumer space, right? Because we're talking, as you were saying, decades. And even like for some industrial machines, being 10, 20 years old is not old. So they're well-maintained and they are designed for one task that they do really well. And now we want indeed to connect them to the internet. It seems indeed that it's not trivial, not easy, but I hear that you guys, along with some of the Microsoft services are trying to make it plug and play. So we're used to that in the consumer world, especially, and just like getting that thing, connecting into that other thing and boom, just works. So how do we do that for the industrial IoT where, as you were mentioning, it's like different types of hardware, different types of communication protocols, different types of everything. So tell me a bit about your venture here. You created a company that aims at simplifying this kind of things. How do you do that?
Sure. And just let me put that in a little context. So, I mean, today we're really talking about weeks to connect one machine to the cloud, right? So it's a big, big issue in the industry. We've actually worked pretty closely together with Microsoft to change that and make that whole process plug and play. So we can now connect machines in minutes or hours to the cloud. And it's actually that simple that I could just show you right here, the entire process.
Let's look at that. I love that. Let's look at
it. Perfect. Then let me quickly change my camera over to my demo environment. Okay, so this is my demo suitcase right here. And what we see as an edge gateway, that's the CloudRail box, which is basically connected to the internet or the cloud here. And through this other Ethernet port, you can either connect to modern machines through standards or industry standards like OPC-UA, or for older machines, so the 30 to 40-year-old machine I mentioned earlier, the idea is really to use additional sensors, so-called secondary sensors, to retrofit that machine. So you would connect to an I/O module, and to that I/O module, you can connect various industrial sensors, so something like this vibration sensor from IFM, this is, for example, a pressure sensor from Turk, temperature sensor, or even actuators like this little stack light here from Balov. And the cool thing is you can connect almost any industrial sensors. So it supports over 12,000 different sensor models. And the whole setup is super, super simple. So you just buy all those components, you plug them all together, you scan a QR code, and that's pretty much it. So it's really plug and play, no coding, no configuration, nothing. It just plug things together. And then it basically takes you into the so-called device management cloud from here.
Is it fair to say you guys are taking advantage of the fact that the industrial IoT or the industry world has been standardizing these connectors and the protocols for communicating between or controlling these devices, right? And that IO port part here uses this kind of standards.
Exactly. So for the sensors, we're basically using a standard called IO link. And what we've got is a huge database, so over 12,000 device models, basically. So semantic information about a lot of industrial sensors typically used in factories.
So you add the CloudRail gateway here, and then what's next?
Right. So we scan the QR code, and that takes us to the device management cloud. So this is basically the device management cloud. It's a software as a service offering. You just create an account, you log in at your devices, and then you have an overview of all your edge gateways. And yeah, mine is this one here, demo case Felix. And now we want to connect some sensors. So just click new connection here. And then we basically have the choice of connecting through OPC-UA to modern equipment, or use directly connected sensors basically to retrofit old assets. So what we're doing now is use direct connected sensors. So I'll just click here. And the next screen, we see that the system found one I/O module with 8 ports, and we see the sensors I showed earlier basically already appearing here. To show you that it's really plug and play, I'm just adding another sensor. So what I've got here is basically a laser distance sensor. And I'll just plug it in.
Okay. And that's where the plug and play meaning comes into play, right?
Exactly. So just plugged in that photoelectric distance sensor. And a few seconds later, it should just appear. Yep, here it is. And again, this works for almost any industrial sensor out there. Just select a sensor. Basically, I tell the system how often to send data to the cloud. So let's take 1 second here. And in the next step, I define the target. So for Azure, we can either send data into IoT Hub, into IoT Central, or an IoT Edge instance, which can optionally run on the device.
Okay.
So now we said we go with Central.
Yeah. So here you're in CloudRail portal. You're managing your devices through the gateways that are on the field installed next to the sensors. We see you have an option between different clouds. Pretty much, everything is out there, which is great because that means that customers can have these hybrid configuration where they want to send data here or there. And Azure is one of the options. Love it. So then you want to connect.
It works in parallel. So you can connect one sensor to multiple clouds if you want to. But now we definitely go for Central. So I'll click here. I just select my credentials and give the device a name. So let's call it Distance and hit Create. Now, what the system now basically does in the background is calls the IoT Central API. So really the customer's IoT Central environment adds the new device with the name Distance and also provides semantic information for that respective sensor. This case, it's really a full PNP model. So a description of the sensor or the capabilities of the sensor. So this is done now. So we're good to go. So what I do now, I switch tabs into IoT Central. So here we are in Azure IoT Central. I already created a little dashboard just for demo purposes. And if I switch over to devices, then I see, hey, there has been a temperature sensor already been connected. A new sensor just appeared called Distance. And if I click on it, it already shows me basically the distance in centimeters. So system knows it is a distance sensor, system knows the unit, and can basically right away work with the data. And this works exactly the same for almost any other industrial sensor. So you can really pick and choose the right sensor for your use case, just plug it in, connect it, and boom, you've got your first IoT project up and running, actually.
Yeah, and here you in the CloudRail Cloud took care of exposing that model you were describing that feeds into IoT Central. So IoT Central has this functionality, IoT plug and play, that allows devices to come up with a device model. So CloudRail publishes on the model repository all the models for these, you say, what, 12,000 sensors?
Right.
And that means that an IoT Central application will automatically understand what kind of sensor, what to display, and so on.
Exactly. And I mean, those models can't only be used in IoT Central, but also in different applications, right? So if I'm a software engineer, an ISV, I can also leverage those PNP templates, those PNP models, to build my own app based on that data.
And in that model, you're describing the telemetry that you can visualize, but you're also describing the commands and properties that the device supports, right? Can you show us here how you can control from IoT Central in the cloud industrial devices seamlessly as well?
Sure. For that, I would just create or connect another device. So I'll go back to the device management tool. Back at box details, basically start the flow over again, directly connected sensors. And here we've got an actuator, that tower light. So this one here. So let's just select it, click next, select the mode, next, IoT Central, demo account, give the device a name.
That's funny because you're doing that in a few clicks, not even writing a line of code. You were saying that until now, connecting an initial IoT device takes weeks, if not months, right? And with the testing and so on, here you did that in seconds.
Right. Here we actually go through the entire process live in the show. It's just a few clicks. So this is done now too. I'll go back to Central, go back to devices. Oh, there's a new device called Light. And this one now actually has commands in there. So I can just select. Segment should blink, and it should blink in blue, for example.
Let's bring back also the device camera right now so that we can see what's going to happen when you click save or run. There you go.
All right, so segment blinks in blue, and let's just click run.
Boom.
And it actually starts blinking blue.
Nice.
It's that easy.
That easy, and you're controlling that device from IoT Central, the comfort of your desk and all the way down to the factory floor, which entails some considerations, right? So we need to discuss real quick, how do you translate that really cool demo into a production environment, taking into account scaling, security, and so on? So what does it take to go from what you just showed to an actual solution in production?
This is a very good question because we see so many good demos about industrial IoT, and then the actual issues come when it goes into production, right? Well, the good thing is it's ready for production. So you could take that setup I just showed and actually take it into your factory right now. So it's all industrial grade. It's real industrial sensors coming from the big industrial brands, basically. We do take care of security, so patch management, security patches, remote firmware updates, that's all being handled by CloudRail. So it's really a managed solution, which you can take into production tomorrow and scale to 1,000 installations next week if you want to.
Nice. And one thing I really like is that it's not really intrusive, right? Because you don't modify the sensors and actuators. What you're doing is you're adding a gateway that will do the job of that connectivity to the cloud. And I assume then takes care of all things you were mentioning, scaling, security, and so on. Like, for example, going through layered networks, which is very common in factory floors and this kind of things, correct?
Right. So basically lives in industrial environments and is exactly designed for that use case. And as you said earlier, I mean, adding secondary sensors or secondary sensors network is usually non-invasive. So You don't change the production environment, right? It basically goes on top, collects data for your IoT use case without actually causing or potentially causing issues in your production network.
Nice. Brilliant. Love it. Nice demo, nice explanation, and ready for production. If you learn more, actually, we have a link down here, aka.me/IoT show/CloudRail, where you can learn about the CloudRail solution, how that works, and how you can go to production with that. Felix, thanks a lot for your time today. Have a great day, everyone. Thanks for watching the IoT Show. Bye.